GFriend's newest song, Apple, explores a theme that people are probably a little bit familiar with, temptation. The idea of an apple tree representing temptation is recognizable largely because of the Bible, but it has been used in many places since then. GFriend takes this theme and works it into their storyline to create something wholly unique to them. But before I break down what actually happens in this music video, we need to go back and see where it all started. All of GFriend's previous releases were theoretically summarized at the beginning of the last album, Labyrinth, with the video titled Tale of the Glass Bead Previous Story, and with the storybook that came with the album. By the way, I will leave a link to these like translated storybooks in the description below, so make sure that you look at those if you want to look at them. Between these two pieces of media, we were told the story of a group of girls who were born with glass beads on an island. This glass bead seems to represent the soul, by the way, and an apple, it seems to be sort of represented by the apple itself. They are eventually gifted small magical abilities by Lake, one by one, starting with Soan, but they grow envious of the other's powers. It is implied later on that this causes a lot of problems between them. The narrator also subtly suggests that something else may be at play, and I have previously interpreted this to be a curse, because of the line, "Was this magic truly only a gift?" accompanied by a dark witch-like artwork. I stand by this interpretation currently, especially knowing their connection to witches. After that, we got the Crossroads music video, which shows Una going back in time over and over again, seemingly trying to fix her friend's problems. But it wasn't until this album that we actually discovered what was going on here. In the storybook that came with the Song of the Sirens album, we got a bunch of new information. First, Una was sad, because even though she and her friends had magic, they were unhappy. This trails off with a sentence, "If we gained magic, we thought we would be happy, but instead we..." Now this actually reminds me a lot of TXT's like song titles, especially in Korean with Can't You See Me. Their Korean title also trails off with the word we. It says, "The night the world burned, we." I've previously tied this phrase to like different timelines, like alternate timelines or parallel timelines, so I do wonder if that has to do with GFriend as well, since we do know they also time travel. The image here suggests what happened pretty clearly, even without being explicitly stated. And this is the same image that we see at the beginning of the Tale of the Glass Bead, Butterfly Effect, which came out in tandem with the promotions for this album. It shows many items from past music videos strewn about and broken. Now this video shows Una running from something, following the blue butterflies and a blue light that eventually leads her to the apple tree. And the storybook actually gives us some insight to this that we didn't have previously. In the book, it's described that she was told by someone who is not identified that if she finds the blue butterfly of legend, her power will grow stronger. This tells us a lot about the blue butterflies. We've already previously known that they've been able to turn back time, as we've seen this in previous music videos. But at the very least, Una seems to believe that this blue butterfly will make her magic stronger and thus will help her save her friends. But remember, envy is also a key element to this story. Even though Una in this book seems like she's trying to help her friends, I do wonder how true that is, since she seems to have a constant collection of glass beads in past music videos. She travels through mountains and forests until she finally reaches an old bookstore. The owner tells her about the legend of the butterfly, and how the village used to be known as the Blue Butterfly Village, but because of misuse and evil intentions, the butterflies disappeared. But they were really just asleep, waiting for the people that could handle their special powers. He tells Una that he thinks her magic can awaken the butterflies and turn back time, which we've seen in action, so we know that this is true, and maybe save her friends. He then gives her the box that we've seen previously in Crossroads, but also in the Butterfly Effect video. This box notably has 5 butterflies in it, not 4 like I previously thought because of Crossroads, which means that in Crossroads, after she goes back in time because of the ending of Fingertip, she's used 2 butterflies. We also get a warning from the owner here. He says that every time she uses a butterfly, she will pay a price and her glass bead will darken. We see this again in Crossroads, where 2 butterflies have already left her bead tainted. He also tells her that if she uses the last butterfly, she might see something that she is not yet prepared to handle. Una simply responds that she would do anything to save her friends. The last page shows a lot of information though, because someone else comes to the door and the bookstore owner ominously says, "I see that the next girl has arrived," almost like he was expecting her. It also makes me wonder if he's expecting all of the girls. but I will get into him a little bit in the future.
The girl at the door here is Soan, who we can identify because of the previous storybook, here where she was taller than the other girls, and here where her shadow had a face in it. The hairstyle is the same.
I'm not 100% sure on if he also gives her butterflies or if he gives her a different gift, or nothing at all, just information perhaps. But this whole thing seems to tie her in very well with the events of Apple, because she seems to be like the ringleader that pulls Una into the whole magical situation that happens. Some people have also suggested that this might be tied to the magic shop in BTS, since Una does get an item. And in fact, in one of the VCRs for BTS, Jungkook actually goes to a library and picks up a book about the magic shop, which is how they get there, so I do wonder if maybe it could be tied into that somehow. Anyways, now that we're caught up to all the stuff that happened before the music video, we can start to break down what's in the music video, and there is a lot, so I'm just gonna tell you what I'm covering and then we can go from there.
First, the Apple of Temptation and the glass beads, which are being corrupted red. It sings like a siren and might be tied somehow to Shinbi. The butterflies, which not only turn back time but are immensely powerful and the key instigators to the butterfly effect. The idea of lotus eaters from mythology and the idea of the Minotaur, which is trapped in a labyrinth. The singing star that they mention in Crossroads, and just the idea of stars in general, because they're literally mentioned in all of their lyrics. Like, I don't even have to try hard to try to find a song that mentions something about a star. It's everywhere.
So now that we have the backstory and the themes that I want to cover, let's actually get into breaking down this music video.
And like I mentioned, this music video doesn't really start at the beginning of the music video, it starts at the beginning of the glass bead butterfly effect video. In this, they tell us they are at a crossroads. Now, a crossroads are often defined as something that is neither here nor there, a sort of in-between place. Likewise, this music video seems very deeply symbolic in nature, so it might not be rooted in reality. So I don't know if we should necessarily be taking this music video at face value, but rather the symbolism of things and how it mirrors and ties into other events that will or have happened in the GFriend universe.
I also think it's talking about events that haven't happened yet, that we haven't seen, but might appear in the future.
I think we should not necessarily take this at face value in terms of direct events that are happening, rather look at it in a symbolic way that explains the story thematically, and assume that it mirrors actual events in the GFriend storyline that we haven't been directly told about yet.
It may, in fact, be taking place in an actual mirror, or maybe a dreamscape. But I do think that this reflection or mirror world actually does affect our Eunha, and it might reveal things about other members as well.
Likewise, the music video might be something that's being watched through a glass bead. Look at this scene with Eunha as she gets pulled in. It turns red. There's a familiar shine just on the right side here, which matches up with when they see the red-colored glass bead beside Yuju later on. We have seen the girls using their glass beads to scry before, so they are able to see events through them.
This may imply that Una is being watched here, but who is watching her? And why? Anyways, the storybook for this album actually gave us a lot of context to help explain the previous title track, Crossroads, since it kind of like told us about the butterflies. And I think that this will be the case for the next as well, because this music video doesn't have some of its context explained, like the ending, for example. But it's possible that in the storybook for the third album of this series, we might get a better explanation.
We do know that the temptation that Una comes across, the apple tree, is linked to their glass beads.
They represent the soul and may be one of the reasons that they can use magic at all, even if this magic was a so-called gift from the lake.
Temptation is also an important theme in BTS's Blood, Sweat, and Tears, which this music video sometimes mirrors.
Una wants to become stronger, and as she mentioned in the storybook, she will do anything to save her friends, and becoming stronger is part of that.
If it means tainting her glass bead, then that is something she will sacrifice to bring them all together again. The red signifies this temptation and allure to power, while the black that we see in the beads is tied to the use of the butterflies, as we know. Likewise, I feel like Shinbi is tied very directly to this temptation as well. Her hair is bright red, just like the apples, and she's the only one we see with solo shots in front of the apple tree, both in the beginning and at the end. She's also the one seen giving Una the glass bead at the end here. You can tell from the ring on her finger. Keep in mind, it seems like Una and Shinbi were previously very close before they started to fight. She could be Una's main motivation for trying to become more powerful, on top of her other friends, of course.
and this is what turns her to the butterflies. Like I mentioned, these are seen in so many of the previous music videos. And as we've now learned, the butterflies might play a part in making your magic stronger. Likewise, Una seems to have the ability to awaken them from their slumber, and it's worth noting that we should be suspicious of the librarian who gives the butterflies to Una. He knows all about them, and yet seemingly is unable to actually awaken them himself. Likewise, we don't know why Una ends up there, of all places. Like, why an old library? Actually, who told her to seek out the butterflies in the first place? We are not told a name, simply that it is murmured to her. I think the librarian is suspect and might not have the best intentions. Like I said, he can't use the butterflies. What does he gain from telling this to Una? The butterflies, at first glance, don't seem to play as active of a role in this music video as previously. There isn't any obvious time travel, though we do see the darkening of the bead still, as I mentioned, and these butterflies seem present throughout the music video in many, many ways. And at the end, Una seems to release all of her other butterflies that she's collected at once. And this might tie into their transformation at the end, since the librarian did mention she might not be able to handle what happens if she uses them all, though I do believe it was quite purposeful on the girl's part to end up that way. After all, many parts of the music video almost seem like the steps in casting a spell or having a deep ritual-like meaning, so somehow I feel like if it is the butterflies, they knew what would happen. Hence why they turn into the Black Witches in the second part of the music video. Or it's possible that the consequences of using these butterflies still has yet to be seen. Also, interestingly, in the M countdown stage, we see everyone with their items from one of the concept photos, which I've talked about previously, and Una, who previously had the glass bead and a butterfly on hers, is shown with nothing on the side of the butterfly. Is this because she no longer has them, or because they're not important to her anymore? We see that in the music video, the scale is tilted again after this, the bead no longer carrying the weight that the flower petals seem to carry for her now. So the flowers seem to suddenly be very important, and we were told this through the advertising of the music video in the teasers and whatnot. We got a shot in the trailer that wasn't even used in the final music video, interestingly, of Una eating a flower. It would clearly fit into the scene where they're all like eating the flowers at the table, so I'm not sure why they cut it or removed it, probably to give priority to a different scene, although I can't really say much on that. But what I can speculate on is the strange practice of eating flowers. Notice that a good portion of the food on the table is actually flowers, and as I mentioned, we saw Una specifically eating this flower. I think this might have something to do with mythology. Now, previously we've actually tied G-Friend to the sirens, obviously because of the title of this album, and Odysseus encountered these on his travels in Greek mythology, but he also encountered something else, the Lotus Eaters. These were a people who ate flowers. The flowers would make you forget your worries, something mentioned several times in Apple's song lyrics, and Chief of Interest makes you sort of apathetic. Look at Una after this scene. She seems almost apathetic and dreamy. Interestingly, I wonder if thematically this means that this whole music video happened before Time for the Moon Knight, because she's quite apathetic and in a dreamlike state in that music video. Was it because of this? Apparently, in mythology, when you stop eating the flowers, it will sort of sober you up a little bit, but you always retain that dreamy state. Is this what happens to Una? And to add to the fact that Apple happened before the Time for the Moon Knight music video, we just have to look at the tree here, because they burned down the apple tree. And in Time for the Moon Knight, Yuju can be seen at a gravestone surrounded by cut down trees, maybe indicating that this could have been the apple tree. To bring it back to the Lotus Eaters, simply being around them would bring upon these effects, but kissing them would also be a way to enhance the mind-fogging effect. And finally, it's said that Lotus Eaters actually dream more vividly, even going so far as to share their dreams. Does this pertain to G-Friend as well? Is the mirror world some sort of shared dream between these girls? I would like to remind you that even though I talk about these mythology stories and it does seem to heavily reference like the Lotus Eaters and other things in mythology, it is not going to be a direct like replica of the original stories. In fact, I think they just take inspiration from these original stories and maybe use elements of it to tell their own story. It's likely that the flower is a very powerful sort of magic that sort of makes you become obsessed with it and think about nothing except it. It may even impede Una on her journey. Interestingly, it is Soan in the music video who pulls her into this first room, and she came to the library right after Una in the storybook that we looked at earlier. Did the librarian perhaps tell her some secret about the flowers? I really can't wait to find out more in the future. Speaking of mythology, at the end of this video, they all grow horns, which makes me think of the Minotaur. In mythology, the Minotaur was cursed to wander a labyrinth. However, Ariadne, who we've previously actually tied to Soan, uses a string to lead him to the exit.
However, it wasn't Soan, but Yeren in Fallen Light, who is seen with Yarn. It's also Yeren who's trapped outside of the building in this music video, making me wonder if she's the one to lead them out of the labyrinth, per se.
Actually, why are there two Yerens?
It seems that there's the Yeren that is sleeping in the garden, and the Yeren who is playing with Una. I think the Yeren in the garden signifies that she gets another choice. The butterflies lead her to the center, to the problem. She is locked out, likely because she did not eat the apple and give in to temptation. I wonder if she will get the chance to use the butterflies. It certainly suggests so. Maybe she will lead them back to the exit of the labyrinth.
Oh, and an important distinction to be made, a labyrinth and a maze are not the same thing. A labyrinth is usually a circle shape and it only has one entrance and exit, unlike a maze where there's usually one entrance and one exit, or sometimes multiple exits.
In terms of the map of the soul, you enter the labyrinth in order to explore and find yourself, to do the circle and come out with a better understanding of who you are. Right now, G-Friend seems to be at the center, but what are they doing there again? As I mentioned before, it seems like the girls are performing some kind of spell or ritual as we near the end of the music video. It sort of feels like a spell that they've been working on to craft that has come to its conclusion. Their clothing changes from their white witch to the black witch, as do their intentions. As they transition from white to black, they burn the tree, their magic manifests their horns. It's hard to say if this is some sort of devil or demon horns, or if it's related to the spell or the butterflies, but it does feel intentional, like they're aware that it was going to happen. In fact, even look at the choreography here. It seems like the girls above are casting a spell while the girls below are signifying horns of some sort. Like they're casting a spell to create these horns. And there are legends that say your soul is kept in your hair and they're cutting their hair. They're dancing and kissing, and when Una releases the butterflies, it feels like completion. There's even a moment that they're semi-transparent on the stairs as if they're giving away a part of themselves to complete this spell and somehow embrace the shadow. The lyrics suggest that this takes place towards the witching hour, which historically happens either around midnight or 3 a.m. on varying accounts. It's said to be the time where the veil between other worlds are the thinnest. In the sweet darkness, the witching hour descends. Maybe it's some sort of contract, like selling your soul to the devil, or perhaps to the moon or the star. After all, they seem to know about a singing star.
I mentioned before that the apple, which tempts you by singing, has siren-like qualities, but what if it's meant to show you the star?
If you read the lyrics of their song, Labyrinth, from the previous album, it seems to tell us the story of Apple from a different point of view. In fact, the song feels like the lyrics are fighting each other, a disagreement that's happening. A sweet whisper from afar, come here, go away. Likewise, it also warns of something. Lost in the maze, don't be fooled by the shining fake. Remember in the beginning of the butterfly effect video, they followed the blue light. Is that related to the star, the butterflies, the apple? Does it lead them down the wrong path? Is it the shining fake? By the way, the idea of a bright shining light is seen in BTS's notes as well, so I wonder if this might connect to that somehow. Notably, in TXT's Eternally, it warns that going up the stairs is bad and explicitly states, do not go up the stairs. This might apply here as well, as this action could be a mistake. However, it might also lead into G-Friend's song, Stairs in the North. I walked restlessly, looking forward, and at the end of these stairs, spotlight of the sunlight that has been waiting for me.
It talks about the success that you reach when you're at the top of the stairs, and it implies that there's a lot of envy on your way up. And of course, once they reach the top, it turns to night. There is a fear as they begin to descend, but it is at that moment when the sun begins to rise as they're going down the stairs that they see the beauty that is surrounding them. They describe this as being the secret that they discovered on the north stairs.
So, while the road to this point in the story was a difficult one filled with the backs that they envy, it will be on the climb down the stairs that they will come to appreciate one another. Maybe they have to make this mistake to see and appreciate each other. And watch as the sun, the true shining star, finally rises to illuminate the beauty around them. Is Soan the leader who leads them down a dark path of black magic? Or what about Shinbi? Does Yuju and her strong ties to mirrors in reference to another butterfly in the fingertip music video mean that there are more paths that they can take? What about the darkness we see in Eunji at the end of Crossroads and the concept photos? Is Una gonna be alright? Will Yeren ultimately find a way to lead them out? Will they finally see the beauty that is their friendship? Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed. What are your theories on this? I feel like this music video gave us a lot of questions, so I'm really looking forward to the future, but what do you think? As always, if you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe with notifications turned on so that you're notified every single time I post a video. All of my social media is linked in the description, so make sure that you follow me there if you want to keep up with everything that I am doing. As it is, stay sunny, everyone. Bye! But Unai seems to believe here that the I cannot speak today. The hairstyle is whoa. Oh, what happened there? Let's try that again. Or it's possible that we haven't actually seen the consequences of what these blutterflies. No.